Hello to my CA family and to everyone watching this daily touchpoint. My name is Ralph. Today I'm going to speak to us out of Ephesians chapter 5, which starts with the word therefore. This word therefore lets us know that what we're about to read in this chapter is connected to what came right before it. So in chapter 4, Paul ends by telling us that it grieves God when we don't exhibit compassion and forgiveness towards others. In chapter 5, Paul gives us the how-to for being able to extend compassion, kindness, forgiveness to others. He says, therefore, be imitators of God as dear children. One of my favorite TV commercials, it aired several years ago, was that of a father and his young son. Maybe he was 3 or 4 years old. They were sitting on a couch together watching TV. Well, actually, the dad was watching TV, but the son was watching the dad. He was hyper-focused on everything the dad was doing because he wanted to be just like his daddy. So when his father would fold his arms behind his head, the son would do the same thing. When the father stretched out his legs to put him up on the coffee table, the son did the same thing. Even at a young age, that son knew that before he could imitate his dad, first he'd need to closely watch him. And how do you closely watch someone? From up close. It's the same for us. Before we can be imitators of God, our Father, we need to spend up close time in His presence. Jesus said something amazing, which is recorded in John's Gospel, and it gives us insight into what made His life on earth so powerful and so impactful. Jesus said this, "I only do what I see the Father do, and I only say what I hear the Father say." Can you imagine the incredible impact in your life and to everyone in your life, your family, your church, your coworkers, fellow students, your neighbors, and the world, if you only did what you saw the Father doing and if you only said what you heard the Father saying? As inviting as this may sound, I know that some of us are thinking, Jesus had access to the Father. Jesus was able to see from Him and hear from Him. But how am I supposed to do that? I'm a mere mortal. I have feet of clay. Well, Jesus' disciples once asked Him something similar, and they said, Jesus, show us the Father. Jesus responded by telling Him something that He's saying to us today as well. Anyone who has seen Me has seen the Father. Hebrews 1:3 tells us that Jesus is the radiance of God's glory. And listen to this, it says He is the exact representation of His being. So anytime and every time that you or I would arrange our lives to read the Bible, to attend church, to worship, to spend time in a life group with other believers, to pray, any other spiritual practices, we are abiding with Jesus and seeing the Father's imitation-worthy characteristics, better known as the fruit of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. I want to encourage us that we really can become imitators of God, that it's a reality. It can be a reality for us. It's something that can happen as we choose to make time for Jesus, to abide with Jesus every day. Let's pray and ask God for His help in that. What a great outcome to be imitators of God. Father, thank You that You call us Your dear children, and thank You that You've told us it's possible to be imitators of You, our God. Lord, would You help us with that every day? God, would You help us to make decisions that would help us to imitate You? Help us to spend time with You, Lord. Help us to develop rhythms and habits where we are abiding with Jesus. Thank You, Father, for Your help through the Holy Spirit. We pray this today in Jesus' name. It's been great being with you today. Join us again for another Daily Touchpoint.